What is going on YouTube? Dr. Iron Bat Prime 2.0 back again with this new video. And as you hit this new video, this is basically my showcase and cosplay and just my overall way of how I made and my cosplay on the human spider from, well, 2002's, well, first Spider-Man movie. Now, let me backtrack a little bit. This is a cosplay I want to do this year, and well, it's cosplay of this year that I want to do, and I've had my eye on wanting to do for, I don't know, like a little over, well, like nearly a year now. But this is a cosplay I figured I'd do and nail because, well, I'll admit, I've done a lot of Tom Holland Spy cosplays. And in a way, I figured I'd step out of that line and just do like something different that we barely see, and that would be Tobey Maguire's, well, Human Spider cosplay. And I'm basically doing this cosplay because, I mean, well, I'll admit, part of me is still attached to the, well, first Spider-Man movie with Tobey Maguire. I still like the costume. The first time I saw it, when I was, like, very young, like, maybe 7 or 8 or something like that, I just laughed out loud hard, and it was just funny and cool at the same time. And the idea just came to me on just why the heck not on cosplaying is it. So I'll admit, this is basically everything I have and for this costume. And I'll admit, finding everything and all that took me like a little over a month, maybe, well, 2 months maybe. But I'm finally here with the end result, and I'll do, you'll see me wear it at the end of this video. But let's get down to, well, let me get down and show you everything about this costume. I'm gonna start from the bottom of the feet and work my way up to the top, so here's the beginning. Now these are basically just, well, red and white shoes that I picked up on Amazon. I mean, in the movie he wears like, well, he wears red and white Nikes, and I'll admit, I have looked all over the internet for those kind of shoes. Heck, I've even checked like my local thrift stores, and Goodwill, and I'll be honest, I just couldn't find them. These were like the closest I could find, but these are good enough, and I like them, and these will do the job. Now in the movie, he does wear sweatpants. Well, kinda, yeah. Kinda like how Tom Holland has, well, like, you know, very light blue sweatpants when he's in his homemade suit. Well, for Toby, he wears like a very dark bluish sweatpants, and I do like these. These are pretty simple and easy to find on Amazon, and they were like $20 maybe. But I just overall like them, and I think these are perfect. I've tried them on several times, and they fit. I mean, I know that he also has like a red stripe that goes right down here on like the side of the leg, and I wanted to keep it as accurate as I could, but I'll admit, these'll do, these are fine, and well, just get over it. Now another thing, not super 100% accurate, but the gloves. These are basically like red and white sports gloves that we see him wear, and these are, I don't know what kind Toby wore in the movie, but these are like red and white baseball gloves, I think. They were the closest I could find to what Toby wore in the movie, but I like the design and all that. They were like, and these two were like $20 on Amazon. All of it. More than half the stuff here I got on Amazon, so, and I just went with it. And again, like I said before, just go with it. But they fit me very well, and I really like the design. The only problem is a little tricky to touch my phone because I'm used to wearing like tactical gloves or fingerless gloves. With like, you know, something that would equal, well, going on the tip of my fingers. But these'll do, these are fine, and well, I'm happy with these. Now this is something that I am super, super proud of. The shirt. Now, the shirt came from this one guy on Etsy. I will leave his name like right in the corner or somewhere, so you can check him out. But getting this shirt was like probably the most expensive thing. It was like $50, but it was so worth it. But I overall like the design, and in a way, well, here's what it looked like when I first got it. Yeah, and I'll admit, it didn't look 100% accurate, but then, well, I got myself some black Platifex paint, and I just painted really dark black on, on the inner circle right here, on the spider logo. And, well, I very lightly used it on, like, the edges and just everywhere else. And that's what I got. And I overall like the design of it all, and it's just, it's perfect. And also, well, it does have that back spider logo. So, shout out to Etsy for giving me, well, for letting me find, well, the right kind of shirt that I needed. And finally, the mask. I'll put it on at the end. And you'll see me wear this at the end of the video, but, well, I'm just really happy with the mask. It looks perfect, and I'll admit, it is like, at first I got like this cheap $5 one on Amazon, but then I found one that's a little more accurate to the one that Toby wore in the movie on Etsy. So yeah, and this is what I got. And I'll admit, it fits me very well. It's just one of those, like, ski masks that you get on like Amazon or eBay or Etsy, and I got mine on Etsy for like, well, I actually got two of these for like $20, so hey, I could use the other for, well, for when I go skiing, and this one for when I'm cosplaying as the human spider. And overall, that's basically everything about the costume itself. Now, like I've done with most of my cosplays, I will suit up, I will go to a location that's COVID-free, and, well, I'll do a photo shoot, put the costume on, give you my full-on thoughts and review on it, and I'll admit, this is going to be my first time on doing a wardrobe, well, a full-on wardrobe of it all, because I've tried it all on, but this is going to be my first time of putting everything together. So, let's get outside, and let's do a photo shoot. Okay guys, so that's pretty much a wrap on the photo shoot that I just completed, and just the whole cosplay itself. And I gotta say, I really like how this suit turned out. I'll admit, it's just casual clothes here and there, and I'll admit, it does fit me like a glove, and yeah, some people were staring at me, but I had a lot of weird looks, but that's what happens when you're in the middle of a cosplaying photo shoot. But overall, it was so worth it, and, well, don't worry. At least they're not, well, pressing charges, and I'm in a COVID-free area. But hey, just to continue this without my mask, yeah, that's basically a wrap on the whole outfit itself. Again, I like how it turned out, and again, like I said at the beginning, I wanted to keep this costume 100% accurate to what Tobey Maguire wore in the movie, and again, I mean, sure, it's not 100% accurate, but again, I like how it turned out, and is perfecto. It is great, it's perfect, and I like how it turned out. I mean, sure, I mean, maybe later in the future I might find, like, well, accurate gloves that they use in the movie. Same goes for the shoes and maybe the sweatpants. But I'm happy with what I have right now. I mean, Comic-Con's not really right around the corner. I mean, the only one that I know of is happening in September. And who knows, when I go, this is definitely a cosplay I'll wear. But
again, like I said, I'm happy with the end results. I like how it turned out. And I'll admit, out of all the cosplays I've worn over the years, this one has to be like the second comfiest. Number one, that title goes to, well, my Spider-Man homemade suit. Well, that Tom Holland Spider-War. But yeah, I mean, that's just my opinion, and it's just I just want to step out of the Tom Holland Spider-Man cosplays and do, well, something different, something new, and this, that new and something different. And again, I like how it turned out. It is perfect. And well, if you guys make your own, well, cosplay, well, of the human spider outfit, definitely go for it. And well, because I already have mine. And again, I'd like to give a shout out again to, well, the guys that made the shirt. And sure, I had to do some detailing myself, but it turned out great, and I like how this whole costume turned out. But thank you all so much for watching, and really hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you liked me watching pictures of me, well, talk about the suit and just pictures of the suit. And if you want to see like full up images and all that, pictures will be all over my social media. But other than that, if you want to see me jump around in this thing later in the future, I'm gonna be doing some TikToks in this outfit. But yeah, that's basically everything I can say about this video, everything I can say about this suit. And I'm looking forward to wearing it in the future of like TikToks, Comic-Con, if there are any special cosplaying events or any movie events, like maybe, who knows, Spider-Man No Way Home. I had to bring up that movie because it's coming later in the future. Just to wrap it up on the video, thank you all again so much for watching. Please subscribe if you are new to this channel, if you have not subscribed already, along with hitting the bell down there so that way you are notified whenever my next video is uploaded. And don't forget to also, well, hit the comments. I'm always reading comments down there, so just comment below. And don't forget to hit the thumbs up so I know you like this video or even love it. And don't forget to also follow me on social media, and I just might follow you guys back. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, Facebook, Cosplay Mino, TikTok. All my social media names are right here, so follow me, and I just might follow you guys back. But until my next video, this is Dr. Iron Bat Prime 2.0 signing out, and I will see all of you guys, well, in my next video.